to keep you company. It is the iconic movie musical that is as popular as ever, 40 years after its release. And for one actor in Greece, it was not just the chance to star alongside his idols, but it also launched his stellar career. Lorenzo Lamas had his big break in Greece and sat down with our Ange Bishop to reminisce about his time as a jock from Rydell High.
Sandy!
Tell me about it, Stir.
It was 40 years ago that the big screen lit up with the gang from Rydell High. Sandy, Danny, Rizzo, Kaniki and Frenchie.
Summer sun, something's begun, but the summer night.
Greece is a classic that lives on for decades thanks to those catchy tunes and great characters.
I'm amazed at the longevity. It keeps finding new generations of people.
Lorenzo Lamas was Tom, the blonde-haired jock who competes with Danny for Sandy's heart. In reality, Lorenzo was a die-hard fan of Olivia Newton-John, and the role was a dream.
I was 19. It was only the third thing I'd ever done, and I was on the Paramount lot meeting my childhood crush, Olivia Newton-John, and Mr. Saturday Night Fever, John Travolta. So I was kind of in a complete zombie state. To begin with, I called all my friends from high school. I went to a private school, a military school back east in New York. And a couple of friends of mine and I were huge fans of Olivia. We had all of her albums. After Evening Mess, we had an hour after our study hall to just kind of goof around and do whatever. And we had like Temptations routines, you know, all worked out with her albums.
What was your favourite ONJ song back then?
Mellow.
Have you never been mellow? Have you never tried?
Her first album, we played it from first song to the last song almost every night. And we also, you know, also played Led Zeppelin and, you know.
That's an interesting mix. Were you able to keep your cool when you met her on set?
Absolutely not. No, I was an idiot. An idiot.
I guess mine is not the first heartbroken.
One day, I had my wardrobe, I got in my costume, and I went to knock on her door. I just got the nerve to do that one morning. I didn't know what I was going to say, but I knocked on the door, and her sister, Rhoda, answered the door. She goes, "Oh, hi. Do you play the jock?" And I go, "Yeah, I'm playing Tom." She goes, "Oh, lovely to meet you, blah, blah, blah." And I go, "Is Olivia inside?" She goes, "Why, yes, can I give her a message for you?" And I'm thinking on my feet, I'm going, "Can you ask her if she'd like me to get her some coffee?" And, you know, she laughed and she goes, "Yes, Lorenzo, I'll ask her." So she left, she went back, I guess to the back of the trailer, came back, she goes, "You know, Olivia's just fine. You won't need to go get her anything." I was just so enamored by her. Yeah.
Yeah.
Couldn't take my eyes off her.
In 1981, Lorenzo became a part of another cultural phenomenon, starring in the TV drama Falcon Crest.
Again, I was very young.
Yeah.
I got that television series when I was 21 and I was on it for 9 years.
That's a huge part of someone's
life. I really
life.
Grew up learning how to act from people that had been doing it for a long time and were very good at it and very well respected.
Falcon Crest was vintage 80s soap, wealthy families feuding and scheming against each other. Lorenzo played Lance, a ladies' man with a playboy lifestyle. The character was grandson and heir to the wealthy Angela Channing, played superbly by Jane Wyman, a renowned star of the golden age of Hollywood and the first wife of President Ronald Reagan.
It's funny because most people didn't think she had a sense of humor because she was so well prepared. She came to work to work.
Yeah, right.
She didn't come to work to hobnob and waste time and spend a lot of time in a dressing room fluffing. She came to work made up.
Prepared.
Made up.
Wow.
All she had to do was throw on her wardrobe and she was on the set. And during lunch break, she would play cards, poker, with the crew.
Oh, I like that.
That's the kind of person she was. Very, very down to earth and very serious minded, but still a great, warm, and genuine person. person.
That sort of movie star person that you really get a sense of.
The movie star without the diva attitude.
So were there people on set of Falcon Crest who didn't get on? Were there some divas?
There were. I remember specifically when Lana Turner came to do a couple of shows and Jane didn't like her.
Okay.
I don't like you, Angela. I don't like anything about you.
They had some history.
Over a man?
Not over a man, I don't think. It might have been over some parts that maybe went to other people. Yeah. There was some history there. And Jane was very professional. Mm-hmm. But like I said, she didn't make a fuss. She wasn't in the makeup trailer, you know, for hours. And Lana was. So she made Jane wait, I think, 2 or 3 times, and then there was no more Lana.
Right.
Lorenzo is the only member of the cast to appear in every episode of the hit soap opera and experienced firsthand the passion that fans had for Falcon Crest and how they loved to hate his character.
There were times when people would literally come up to me and say, you know, you should treat your grandmother better. And why are you doing that to your wife? What kind of person are you? And I would say, I'm just acting. Because soap opera fans are out of their minds with their fan-ness. They're just obsessed. I got hit by an older woman with a bag of apples. She goes, you are just the most horrible person. You should treat your wife better. I go, which one? Because I had been married twice at that time. She goes, your wife, Melissa. I go, on the show?
Show business is in Lorenzo's blood. His mother, Arlene, was a Hollywood star of the 40s and 50s. And his father, Fernando, was a director who even directed some episodes of Falcon Crest.
My father, Fernando Lamas, was an actor and a director and very successful in his own right. And my mother, Arlene Dahl, also was very successful. And they had two completely different philosophies about publicity.
And who was which?
Well, my dad always told me to not do the publicity unless you're publicizing a work that you're doing, a movie or a television show.
Okay.
And my mom was the opposite, you know. If I was in between television series or movies or something, she'd say, Lorenzo, take that girl you're seeing and go out and get your picture taken. Go to a restaurant. Go to a red carpet event. Do all that stuff.
Who was right?
At my life, my dad probably was the one that I should have listened to.
He went from sharing a Sunday with Our Livy in Greece to smouldering up the small screen on Falcon Crest. And Lorenzo even had a stint as a judge on a beauty contest reality show and featured Kiwi supermodel Rachel Hunter as a fellow judge.
What did the judges think about Candace? Not.
So did Lorenzo think a Greece tribute from some fans down under was hot or not?
Who's playing Danny?
Joe Hildebrand is one of the hosts of our...
Very cool.
He is very cool. And then Sarah, there's Eugene, that's Craig. This is Sarah playing Sandy. She looks good.
She looks really good. Very well done.
Good guy. I think
that's
we all know what the take-home message from that was, don't we, Tash?
What is the take-home message, Joe?
That I'm very cool.